Hi, this is Katarina and Isara from I Was Diagnosed, and we would like to talk to you about heroes and anti-heroes.
Yeah, this is a pretty important topic, I think, and not something that a lot of people think about when they're dealing with autoimmune disorders, like as a distinct thing, like consciously going after heroes. So one of the things, like when Katarina was diagnosed, there were a couple people, we just started Googling and searching stuff, and we immediately found a couple people. In particular, there was this one woman, she had a website, the self-healing coach.
Yeah, her name was Karen, is Karen.
Is Karen, and there was something just really inspiring about her. And then another hero is also Terry Wahls, and sort of her journey and her path, but just specifically, I think for both of us, that she's just so, she's just focused. And she doesn't seem to deviate a lot, and she's just hardcore. And we really, really like that.
Yeah, we've been following her since I was diagnosed for the last 6 years. And throughout the entire time, she remained the inspiration for me and for Isara.
Yeah.
To the point where sometimes, you know, when we think about what things to eat, we would like, well, what would Terry eat? Or like, what would Terry do? Or, you know, like some combinations might not quite feel right to my taste, but there is a ton of nutrition in there. We're like, well, Terry would totally approve that, right? And we just like go for it.
Yeah, I think one of the things too with her is like her background's in competitive sports. And so it gives her an edge. I mean, I don't know her. She's really inspirational, but it seems like that's an edge that she has. And I think that's a really important mentality to have when you're dealing with like an autoimmune thing, is you have to be so committed, so consistent that you're really looking at things like, you know, sports, like competitive sports, like that world, and how those mindsets get, how people use those mindsets to achieve results. So that's the thing. The other thing is anti-heroes. So there's three aspects to this. So there's one is like finding heroes. The other is being a hero for somebody else.
And role model.
Or a role model, which is really, really important. So one of the things Katarina noticed is that there's a few people around her who've articulated that like, that you inspire them. And then you've shared with me that like, that makes you feel like you really got to stick to what you're doing, like really not deviate.
Yeah, exactly. Like they specifically shared, I inspire them to stick to the diet. I inspire them to go swim, something they normally wouldn't do.
I think that's just so awesome. And then the last category is my favorite, is like your anti-hero, like people in your life. I'm not going to say because they might watch this, but people close to you perhaps who have inspired you to not do certain things. Mm. And so I'll take on, if I'm about to make a decision and there's a person who I consider to be a pretty bad decision maker in my life, you know, I can always ask, what would one of my heroes do? But then to reverse it and to get more leverage, I always ask myself, like, you know, what would this person specifically in my life do? And then kind of do the opposite of that. So in this case, if you know somebody who's like really not good with dieting or exercise or any of these things that you have to be committed for, you know, you could try and imagine them doing this and making the opposite, you know, choice. So anyway, that's just a cool topic that I think we both wanted to share because we've gotten a lot of leverage from that.
Yeah, exactly. It's a cool distinction to make to help yourself either stick or to be pulled towards something or away from something.
Yeah, just being really clear on like who those people are.
Yeah.
Awesome. All right, thanks for watching. Hit subscribe, follow, we'll send you more cool stuff, and that's it for now.
That's it.
Okay.